Now we consider the implementation of the all-important page table data structure, which needs to translate virtual page numbers into physical page frames. Virtual page numbers start at 0 and then go up by 1, so the most straightforward way to do this would be to create a giant array that is the number of pages long. Let's see how this strategy might work. Suppose that we have a 48-bit virtual address and a 32-bit physical address, and let's say pages of size is 4K. We've used up 12 bits for the offset, leaving 2 to the 36 possible virtual page numbers. That means that we need an array 2 to the 36 long, each entry probably having 4 bytes to specify the physical address, which brings us to a total of about 256 gigs, which is more memory than most machines have in RAM. And of course, almost all of it is wasted, since most virtual addresses aren't used. Even with just 32-bit virtual addresses, we would still need a page table with 2 to the 20th entries, and that would put us on the order of several megabytes. And of course, we need one page table per process. So instead, page tables are done in a hierarchical way. In our 32-bit example, the highest order 10 bits are used as an index into a top-level page table. The contents of this page table then give us the base address of another page table. We use the next 10 bits as the index into that lower-level page table. And the contents of that page table then give us the physical page number. Why does this help us use less memory? Well, recall our virtual address space. We use addresses at the bottom, and we use addresses at the top, but there's a vast empty region in the middle. Many of these unused addresses will have the same 10 high-order bits, and for these, we won't even have a secondary table. Thus, we end up using not too much more memory for the page table than we really need to. The particulars of the actual page implementation vary greatly. Some have 3 levels, others have 4, but they all use this basic hierarchical strategy.